Hi there, I am Angie and I am the founder, heart and soul of Bobo Design Studio, and I wanted to share with you some of my favorite writing tools to use inside my Wanderlust Passport. I get a lot of questions on what kind of pens I use to create the different pages I've shared so far, but not only that, you know, which pens work best. I know for me, nothing grinds my gears more than ink bleeding through the paper. So I was pretty thoughtful when I created this book. When I designed it, I wanted nice, hearty pages, but ones that wouldn't be too bulky once you started adding things like photos and train stubs and washi tape. So the pages aren't thick, but they're also not thin like printer paper. So with the exception of permanent markers, it should hold up pretty good to most water-based inks and markers. So, being the pen collector and hoarder that I am, I want to run through some of my favorite tools and share with you what I have been using in my books. In no way, shape, or form am I sponsored by Tombow. I am not cool enough to be sponsored by Tombow. I have paid for this insane collection of pens with my own cheddar. I have spent a small fortune. I'm not even ashamed to admit that. But, you know, hey, if Tombow wants to throw a few pens at me, I am not going to say no. But know that everything that I am sharing is stuff that I am big, big fans of and that I have purchased with my own Skrilla. So we shall start with the monotip pens. I have here a 3 and a 5, which is basically just the size of the little nib thing. I don't even know what that's called. See, this is why they would never give me free stuff, because I don't even know what stuff's called. But these pens, they give nice, crisp, clean lines, and they're great for writing a lot of text. So another pen that I think is pretty comparable to this that I also like is the Sakura Micron, which is an alcohol-based pen. But if I had my pick, I would definitely go with the Tombow monotip pens. Then there are the Tombow Fudenosuke pens, or as I like to call them, Fudes. And it's not because I'm cool, it's just because I can never remember the whole word Fudenosuke. So they offer two different types of pens. One has a flexi tip and one has more of like a firm tip. I love them both. I was happier than a seagull with a french fry when the colored versions of the Fudes came out. The pigments are really awesome. I wish I could do one of those cool like swatches like Kylie Jenner does with her lip gloss, but that would look really stupid because I have like scars from hot glue guns and mosquito bites all over my arms. Tombow also makes these dual tone pens, which are really cool. They're kind of pastel-y. They come in a set, so again, you don't even have to think about it. You just grab a set, take that on the road with you. They're dual tip, meaning that they've got one end is like a marker, and then the other end is a really, really fine pen tip, so you can get really crisp, clean lines. And then, of course, there is the dual tip pens, a necessary item for any hand letterer. I'm a total psycho and I have enough pens to fill this gigantic box. I know this looks very, very overwhelming, similar to the menu at Cheesecake Factory. Like, why is that menu so big? Why is it spiral bound? And are there ads in there? Like, it's just way too much. Anyhow, you don't have to feel overwhelmed when looking at pens, because Tombow, in their amazing wisdom, has actually taken the guesswork out for those who want to use complementary colors, but then sees this whole, like, you know, assortment and thinks it's like way too much creative freedom. So they assemble these sets that have different themes. This one is the landscape palette, which is very landscapey, clearly. And the next that I'm going to show aren't really writing tools per se, but my favorite things to use when building my entry pages. This is the mono correction tape, which is basically like whiteout. Yes, this still exists. I know kids these days just text things like BRB and MRW and don't know the woes of having to put water in a bottle of crusty whiteout and dab that dried up sponge onto their term paper and then write over it again. But you know, whiteout is a thing. And I'm so excited that it still comes in this tape because I love using this. Speaking of tape, I also like to use washi tape. These cover mistakes so well. And if, you know, thoughtfully cut or trimmed, it can add a lot of color and kind of pizzazz to your pages without you actually having to draw anything. So that's always a bonus. Tombow also makes this double-sided tape dispenser, which works awesome for, you know, securing Polaroids or ticket stubs inside your book. Paper Source also has a branded one that's pretty affordable. It comes in like a dual pack. I also like those. And finally, my absolute favorite thing is the Fuji Instax printer. OMG, I totally love this thing. I also love my little Instax camera, but if you've ever used one of those Instax Polaroid cameras, you have to be like 2 inches away from your subject in order for it to look good. Not super feasible, one, when you're backpacking and you can only carry so much, or if you've got a great photo of like the Grand Canyon, you are not gonna get that on a little Polaroid camera. So the Instax printer basically syncs to your phone via Bluetooth, and you're able to print pictures straight from your camera roll, or maybe you've got some DSLR photos on there in your camera roll. And the printer is super fast. It has its own editing tool in there, so if you wanted to like do any edits to your photos before you print them, you could do that. But it's a great way to kind of pare down all the thousands of photos you took of this tree, pick your favorite one, and then slap that in your book. So these are a few of my favorite things. Definitely stay tuned and follow and subscribe to my channel, because I'm going to show some of my tips and tricks on what to do when you've messed up in a page. I know for me, I tend to be pretty sloppy and I mess up, and the last thing I want to do is rip a page out from my book. So I show you some cool tips and tricks to help avoid that. And I'm going to be showing you how I fill out some of my entry pages. So definitely stick around. If you're not following or subscribed, do that now. And you know you can always find me on Instagram, Bobo Design Studio, or purchase a Wanderlust passport at bobodesignstudio.com. And I'll include links in the caption thingy below. But I think that's it for now. So I'll see you later. Bye.